Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss triple integrals in spherical coordinates. Our example is to evaluate the triple integral of x squared plus y squared plus z squared over e, where e lies between the spheres x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 4 and x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 16. Let's go ahead and work through it. Solution. But first, recall the formulas for spherical coordinates. First one says that x is equal to rho sine phi cosine theta, and y is equal to rho sine phi sine theta. So notice that they both have the rho sine phi, which makes it a little bit easier to memorize, and z is equal to rho cosine phi. We also have a very important formula that we're going to use in this problem. It's that rho squared is equal to x squared plus y squared plus z squared. And you see that multiple times here in this problem. You see it in the integrand, you see it in the spheres, so it's super, super useful. Also, we know that rho is greater than or equal to 0, and phi is between 0 and pi. A lot of formulas, and the very last one is perhaps the most important. They're all important, but this one is key. It's dv, right? We have a dv here, and we need to eliminate it in our problem. So we're going to replace dv with rho squared, sine phi, okay, sine of phi, and then d rho, d theta, d phi. I'm going to put this one in a box because it's very important. This is key for the integration process, which is what we're doing in this problem. Should mention here that this sphere, x squared plus y squared plus z squared equals 4, can be represented by rho squared equals 4. If you take the square root of both sides, you do get a plus or minus, but rho is greater than or equal to 0, so you only care about the plus. So you can write this as rho equals 2. Likewise here, rho squared is 16. So you can write this as rho equals 4. Very nice, right? Way to simplify the equation of the sphere with just a simple equation. All right, so now we're ready to do it, right? We're going to go ahead and write the integral down. We have the triple integral. And then we have x squared plus y squared plus z squared. So that's just going to be rho squared. We have our dv, which I wrote down there on the left. So that's going to be rho squared. Sine phi, and then d rho, d theta, and then d phi. So now we have to think about the limits of integration. We have to come up with those. It's pretty easy in this case. So rho is going to go from 2 to 4. And then theta, we did rho first, by the way, because it says d rho. So you do rho first. Then you go to theta. Well, we have spheres, so this is going to go from 0 to 2 pi. And then phi is going to go from 0 to pi, as we specified earlier. Very nice. Okay, let's keep going. This is equal to the definite integral, well, triple integral, from 0 to pi, and then another definite integral, 0 to 2 pi. All I'm going to do in this step is just multiply rho squared times rho squared. So I'm just going to copy everything down again, 2 to 4. And that's rho to the fourth. Then we still have the sine phi, d rho, d theta, d phi. Really easy to mess up here. So let's be really, really careful. So this is equal to, I'm going to come way over here just so I have more room. This is the triple integral. Well, double integral, because now I'm going to integrate, right? We're going to integrate now. We're going from 0 to pi, 0 to 2 pi, and we're integrating rho to the 4th, so we add 1 and divide by the exponent, so we get rho to the 5 over 5, and we're going from 2 to 4. We still have the sine phi, but we no longer have the d rho because we integrated, okay? That's very key. So d theta, d phi. Okay, so the notation here is key. So we integrated, we dropped the d rho, we wrote down our numbers. So this is 0 to pi. And then we're going from 0 to 2 pi. You plug in the 4, subtract, plug in the 2. So we get parentheses 4 to the 5th over 5 minus 2 to the 5th over 5 parentheses sine phi. And then we have d theta d phi. Okay, if you work this out, 4 to the 5th over 5 minus 2 to the 5th over 5, you end up with a big number. You get 992. So this is equal to the integral from 0 to pi, the integral from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, and this is 992 over 5. And then we still have sine phi d theta d phi. Now we can integrate with respect to theta. So all of this is constant with respect to theta. So we're basically going to get the integral from 0 to pi. And then we're going to get 992 over 5 sine phi. And then we're going to have a theta here. And we're going from 0 to 2 pi. And then we have our d phi. Right, because everything here is constant. Everything I've circled here is constant with respect to theta. So it's like you're integrating 2. You would just get 2 theta, except in this case, it's not 2. It's 999 over 2. 992 over 5 times sine of phi. That's your constant. So this is equal to the integral from 0 to pi. So you plug in 2 pi for the theta, subtract, and then plug in 0. So you're going to get 992 over 5 sine phi times 2 pi, and then subtract and plug in 0 so it goes away. So we just get now d phi, right? Because when you plug in 0, it goes away. All right, almost there. Let's multiply the 2 times the 992, and that's going to give us the integral from 0 to pi. Multiplying those, we're going to get 1984. So 1984, it's like a year. 1984 pi over 5 sine phi d phi. And now we can integrate with respect to phi. The integral of sine is going to be negative cosine. This is going to be negative 1984 pi over 5 cosine phi. And we're going from 0 to pi. So this is equal to 1984 pi over 5. Plug in pi, you get cosine of pi minus cosine of 0. Okay, very nice. So this is equal to negative 1984 pi over 5. And then cosine of pi is negative 1. And then cosine of 0 is 1. So we get negative 1984 pi over 5 times negative 2, right? A lot of computations here. And finally, we can multiply these numbers. We get to the end. And there's some that are harder than this. This is 3968 over 5 and then times pi. And that would be the answer. But the key is really at the beginning, just memorize the formula, right? If you can start it, it's better than not being able to start it. And honestly, once you set it up and you find your limits, you can get pretty good at this. So yeah, and a lot of the problems are similar. A lot of the problems use this rho squared equals, you know, x squared plus y squared plus z squared. So hopefully this video has been helpful, and hopefully you've learned some math. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck and take care.